And we're back. Wait for some people to join. Yeah, so I couldn't get to sleep until about 3:30 last night because I was just lying in bed. Full of endless questions created by this game. Why? Why? If you want to know what's going on with Todd, Todd was murdered by me. I shot Todd. Kara, the robot, is now a crime bot. I killed Todd, and I stole some clothes from a laundromat, and I robbed a convenience store. Todd Man died, and I repaired my mind palace, found Jericho with Marcus. And saved my boyfriend, Hank, from falling off of a ledge. And now he's my friend. And that's the most important thing. And restarted the game so that Connor would wink saucily because the most important thing is that the cops kiss. Right, I'm gonna get started.
Who are you? Fugitives. Just like you. My name is Josh.
I'm Simon.
North.
Then you knew that only an android could follow the trail, didn't you? Only those who are like us can find Jericho.
If you could decipher the signs, it's because one of us trusted you enough to give you the key.
There's a place where we can be free. Find Jericho!
And hiding just to stay alive, that's freedom to you?
Humans hate us. Hiding is the only way we can survive.
There is no safe place for those like us. If humans knew we were here, they'd kill us.
How many are you?
There are 19 of us still in working order. The rest were damaged escaping their masters.
Many tried to reach Jericho. Few succeed. Humans have little pity for our kind. I understand how you feel, but we have more freedom here than you ever did.
Humans were your masters, and now it's fear that rules you. You're no freer than you ever were. You've only found a new master.
You're lost, just like the rest of us. We didn't ask for this. All we can do now is deal with it.
You're safe here. You can stay with us as long as you want.
Go and see Lucy. She might be able to help you.
Marcus just permanently has like the most like raggedly torn Henley type shirt that just is perfectly hot. Hot bot. All right, let's dig through some trash. Yes, androids, as we know, need to gather around things for warmth.
I'm not in very good shape, am I? My diagnostic program isn't working. would have anything good to say anyway.
What happened to you?
They tied me to the back of a car.
I recognize that actor.
I think they wanted to have fun. I don't want to shut down. No, I don't want to shut down.
Humans are afraid of dying too. Do you know what happens after death?
No. No, I don't.
I have a question, and it's how did Marcus get all his skin back? His skin was really problematic when we last left him. Her skin isn't fine.
I guess
it's nano skin or something. I do love looking at Jesse Williams, though. Well,
they threw him out when they didn't want him anymore.
Sean?
He was living on the streets before we brought him here.
Sean!
They'll all shut down if we don't find a way to help them.
To help them, we need blue blood and biocomponents. We salvage what we can from those who shut down. But there's never enough.
So, how do they survive?
They won't.
Yeah, how did the ones that are fucked up... I had to do a bunch of parkour to get here. How did the broken ones get here? Maybe they were brought by their buddies. I don't know. Oh, there are no answers. Only more questions. Oh, the crate of legs.
What was your function before coming here?
What do you care?
Okay.
A lot of these guys in pretty bad shape.
That's how the humans treat those who disobey. They despise us. They'll never accept what we are.
These guys need spare parts and blue blood. Why hasn't anybody gone to get that?
It's not that simple. Can't just go shopping at a CyberLife store. Anyway, nobody wants to risk leaving Jericho. If you came here for comfort, you came to the wrong place.
So do androids regularly need blue blood, or do you only need them if you get hurt? Are androids vampires is what I'm asking. Oh, another. Let me light all these with this lighter I have for some reason. Follow to my meaningful humming. I'm sure I won't hate this.
Are you Lucy?
Sit down. Show me. I'll stop the bleeding. Drink this. Give me your hand. You had it all, and you lost it all. You've seen hell, and now hell lives in you. Your heart is troubled. A part of shadow and a part of light.
Excuse me.
Which will prevail? Your choices will shape our destiny.
Yes, David, I know. I do sneeze like a little kitten. Yeah, I know. Propose to Simon. Well, we just met. Where is he? There he is.
Simon. I know where we can find spare parts. Cyberlife Warehouse is in Detroit Harbor. They have everything we need.
The docks are guarded. We can't just walk in there and take what we want. Humans will never let us.
Which is why we won't ask permission.
We don't have any weapons. And even if we did, none of us knows how to fight.
We can steal what we need without fighting.
We'll just get ourselves killed.
Maybe. But it's better than waiting here to be shut down.
I'm with you.
Maybe it's worth a try.
Men.
I did everything in that chapter. I lit all the lights. That was important. Alright, let's do some crimes.
You gonna be okay?
Do you think androids are like cold to the touch or warm?
As soon as we're all, just a bad memory.
place.
Are they like room temperature? I mean, that would be a pretty automatic tell. I need to understand these things before I start writing my Connor Hank fanfiction. Man, David Cage, you are horny for rain. Let's break in. Crime.
Are you Zlatko?
Who's asking?
I was told you could help us.
I don't know who told you that. You came to the wrong place. I'm sorry.
Wait. We really need your help.
Come in. Come on in. Don't be shy.
An emu over there. Yeah, okay. Just your stately, normal chocobo. I love the interior design and David
Luther,
Cage's bullshit.
Would
and
you
I,
be so
I mean
kind
that
as to take these ladies' coats? Oh, don't be afraid of our big friend here. Luther is just another android that I helped. He keeps me company in this big, empty old house.
Keeps me company.
Please. Make yourselves at home.
The big boy model.
How did you hear about me?
An android. On the street, he said you could help us.
I see. Devian, huh? What about her?
She's human.
And you want to find a safe place. Somewhere you can start a new life. I hear Canada is very lovely at this time of year. Beautiful landscapes, open spaces, clean air, and no android laws. Great place for a fresh start.
Yes, that's exactly what we want.
Of course. I can help you. But first, we have to get rid of your tracker.
Tracker?
Yeah. All androids are fitted with a tracking device to locate them at all times. I'll remove yours, and then you'll both be safe. Come on.
So how have the cops not, like, immediately known where she is? Because assume...
Oh. David. The little one can wait for us in the living room.
No.
David. Can I talk to Luther?
Of course. Right this way? Everything we need is in the basement.
Yeah, this is gonna go well. I've had great luck going to basements in David Cage games before.
I don't like this place. And that man. Let's go, I have a bad feeling.
It'll be okay, Alice. He's going to remove my tracker, and then we can start over again in Canada. You want that too, right?
There's stables down here?
Please excuse the mess. I needed somewhere discreet for my machines. Removing trackers is illegal, so I opted for discretion over comfort. I hope the little one isn't too scared.
No. No, she'll be all right.
That's good.
She's just being creepy.
Come on, Alice.
This way, please. If you could just stand over there. I should warn you, this could be quite unpleasant.
Androids can't feel pain! They specifically told us androids can't feel pain.
You know
what's
strange?
Why are you scared?
For some unknown reason, the trackers seem to stop working in Deviants. That's why it's so hard to find them.
Oh. Right.
So, actually, there's no reason to remove your tracker.
What? But you said that...
Yeah. People believe what they want. You deviants are so naive. They all come to me expecting me to help them. And I just reset them, sell them on. Or I keep them for my little experiments.
No! No! I don't want to be reset! Let me go!
Ah! Oh, I forgot about the child. Lock it up. I'll deal with it later.
Alice! Alice, no!
Well, you know what? At least she's not naked.
Wants to be a mother. That's so sweet.
Uh-huh.
And so deluded. I think it's time we put you out of your misery. What you get for having a dream.
It always ends up the same way.
Tears and disillusionment. Believe me, you're better off being erased and feeling nothing.
Can't wait to do a crime to you.
No more pain. No more hopes dashed. I almost envy you.
Kara!
Oh, poor little Alice. Oh, looks like Mommy doesn't remember you at all, huh? Looks like Mommy's completely forgotten you.
Kara, what happened to you?
Oh, all right, that's enough. Come on. You bit me. I'm gonna teach you some manners, you little bitch.
Meet me in the living room.
I haven't been fully reset yet. I could still do crimes.
Thank you.
Is that like when you unplug a hard drive without ejecting it from the disk? Okay. Stables full of androids, I get it.
Help us.
So gooey.
He likes to play with us, creating monsters for his amusement.
Oh. Oh.
But who's the real monster? Look what he did to us.
Well, that's fucked up, and I like it.
Yes, Locke.
Should be done here in 10 minutes or so. So, have a look at the lift.
Wow, I guess I could just leave. That'd be fucked.
Understood, Locke. I'll bring you the little one in 10 minutes.
Arbitrarily take 10 minutes to bring you the little one. Alice might be in there. Why couldn't I? Gas can. Can I not take the gas can? Can I not torch this place? I want to do a crime! Robo Bear! Is it a crime to free a bear? Maybe.
What are you doing here? Has the master authorized you to be here? You must always obey the master. Oh yes, you must always obey. What are you doing? You're not gonna hurt me. No. No. No, you wouldn't do that.
Will you be quiet if I let go?
Yes, yes. I promise to be quiet. Don't turn me off.
Just holding on to... No, I won't just murder this android for no reason.
No, of course not.
It's... I'm not that kind of crime, Mom. Alright, Luther.
I'm sorry. About the little one.
Android model known as Absolute Unit. I don't have time for this. What?
It's not loaded.
Oh, beans. Are you guys booing that I didn't murder that android? Come on. I only kill people. This.
The cashier reports that he was attacked by an android in the company of a little girl.
For the always appropriate news channel. Why am I in this Resident Evil ass house? God damn you, Zlatko. Yeah, it's definitely not a Resident Evil 7 house. It's more like the Resident Evil 1 house.
Luther!
Yes, Slavko?
I'm finished here. Go fetch the little one.
Right away, Slavko.
Hit Luther with a
thank you.
searching the house. We've got to get out before they find us.
Yes! Arson!
We need to hurry. They'll be here soon.
Okay, let's get out of here quickly, please.
Smoke everywhere! Luther! There's a fucking fire! Luther! Treacherous bitch.
He knew where the bullets were. I guess.
I warned you. Dreams always end in tears.
Well,
you should have listened to me. What are you doing? Get out of my way.
No. Not this time.
I said get out of my way or I'll shoot right through you. How dare you? What are you doing? Who let you out? Get away from me! Get away from me!
Where is the
bear?
Where is the bear?
I'm your master!
That bear didn't pay off.
I didn't want to hurt you. He programmed me to obey him. When I saw the little one risk her life to save you, it was like opening my eyes for the first time. Finally, I could see. I know you have no reason to trust me after what I did. But I know someone who could help you across the border. I could take you there. I could protect you. You and the little one.
All right. I trust you.
Metal husband. Yes, a family can be two crime bots and a child.
I'm so scared of losing you.
Where's the bear, though? Yay! Oh, yeah, I guess bathtub android did die after all due to being burned up. I guess I could have murdered him. And now there's just a beat up android polar bear roaming Detroit. It's my boy. Back in this mystical garden. Thank you. are you, lady?
Hello, Amanda.
Connor, I've been expecting you. Would you mind a little walk? That deviant seemed to be an intriguing case. Pity you didn't manage to capture it.
I agree. I may not be suited for this investigation. Maybe you should consider replacing me.
Did you manage to learn anything?
I found its diary, but it was encrypted. I
met my new husband.
It may take weeks to decipher.
What else?
The walls of the apartment were covered with drawings of labyrinths and other symbols. Like the other deviants, it seemed obsessed with RA9.
You came very close to capturing that deviant. How is your relationship with the lieutenant developing?
He seemed grateful that I saved his life on the roof. He didn't say anything, but he expressed it in his own way.
We don't have much time. Deviancy continues to spread. It's only a matter of time before the media finds out about it. We need to stop this, whatever it takes.
I will solve this investigation, Amanda. I won't disappoint you.
You're letting her get wet.
A new case just came in. Find Anderson and investigate it.
Lieutenant Anderson! Anybody home?
Wait, what is... You have stickers on the inside of your car? You nerd.
Lieutenant Anderson! Easy, Sumo. I'm your friend. See? I know your name. I'm here to save your owner.
Thank you.
Lieutenant. Wake up, Lieutenant. It's me, Connor. I'm going to sober you up for your own safety.
Hey!
I have to warn you.
Leave me alone, this may be unpleasant. Fucking android. Get the fuck out of my house.
I'm sorry, Lieutenant, but I need you. Thank you in advance for your cooperation.
We get the fuck out of
here! Daisy.
Sumo!
Attack!
Good job. Attack! Fuck, I think I'm gonna be sick. Oh, leave me alone, you asshole. I'm not going anywhere. What the hell are you doing? I don't want a bath. Thank you.
Sorry, Lieutenant. It's for your own good.
This is wonderful.
Turn it off! Turn it off! What the fuck are you doing here?
A homicide was reported 43 minutes ago. I couldn't find you at Jimmy's bar, so I came to see if you were at home.
Jesus, I must be the only cop in the world that gets assaulted in his own house by his own fucking android. Can't you just leave me alone?
You seem to have personal issues. You should consult a professional who can help you.
Beat it, you hear me? Get the hell out of here!
Tease.
I understand.
Tease.
It probably wasn't interesting anyway. A man found dead in a sex club downtown. Guess they'll have to solve the case without us.
You know, probably wouldn't do me any harm to get some air. There's some clothes in the bedroom there.
I'll go get them.
First, I'm looking at all of your notes on computer enhance. I want to see what the notes on his thing say. Reading a book about tentacles. I want a Snoop!
What do you want to wear?
Whatever.
Are you all right, Lieutenant?
Yeah. Wonderful. Just give me 5 minutes, okay?
Sure.
Gross. President Warren issued a... Learn more about Hank.
An official warning to Russia in her speech to Congress today, where she demanded that all Russian troops withdraw from the Arctic region immediately. The Kremlin has yet to respond.
This is a real variety of food you were going down about.
Many experts are suggesting the specter of a third world war draws closer every day.
Oh. examine it. Stop stepping over it weirdly. Hank, I swear I'll make you happy again. Look at the gun. Look. There we go.
What were you doing with the gun?
Russian roulette. Wanted to see how long I could last. Must have collapsed before I found out.
You were lucky. The next shot would have killed you.
I dressed you up so nice. Oh.
Be a good dog, Sumo. I won't be long.
I'm glad I'm playing this with a chat full of people who also ship it. Alright, Marcus, what's your stupid shit? This is the most cringeworthy part of the plot, leading the Android revolution.
This is crazy! If they catch us, we're dead!
What do we do now?
We need to find the Cyberlife warehouse. That's where they keep the spare parts and the blue blood.
Follow me. Company that's making all the androids? And if so, don't they feel responsible for... Climb up here.
No. The 37% employment rate and civil unrest. Are there international companies also making robots?
Cyberlife warehouses. We have everything we're looking for.
First, we have to get rid of that drone.
Leave it to me.
I'm gonna eat it. good old android rodeo.
You okay?
Yeah, yeah, I'm fine.
Good job, Marcus.
Quick, open the other crates and fill your bags. Take as much as you can.
Where did the others go? Oh. Thank you. Where'd you get a knife? Backpacks.
You were trespassing on private property. Your presence constitutes a level 2 infraction. I will notify security.
John! God damn machine! Where is it this time? John!
I need your help.
John! There you are! What the hell are you doing?
I was inspecting the platform. Everything is in order.
Good. Then I'm going back to the control station. I'm soaked. Take the drone to maintenance and make a report.
Understood.
Now, why did this android decide to not narc on us?
Let's finish up and get out of here. Try to find some blue blood. We still don't have enough.
Great security system here. It's a box full of Chads.
Why aren't you like us? Don't you want to be free? You could join us.
That's all we can carry. Let's go.
Take me with you.
Oh-ho.
He's on their side. We can't trust him.
He took a risk for us. We can't just leave him here.
We can't bring them back with us. It's too dangerous.
They come with us.
I know where you can find more spare parts.
What do you mean?
The trucks. They're full of bio components. They run on autopilot, but they can be driven manually with a key.
Where is this key?
Down there, in the control station. There are two human guards. We'll have to get the key without being noticed.
This is suicide, Marcus. Our bags are full. We got what we came for. Let's go before they catch us.
This is a truck full of spare parts. There'd be enough for all of us. We can't pass this up.
And if we get killed, our people will have nothing. We can't take that chance. It's too risky.
Wait here. If I'm not back in 10 minutes, go without me.
Marcus.
I'm coming with you.
No, I'm going alone. It's not worth it for both of us to risk losing our lives.
Damn dogs. What the fuck are they barking at?
Could be the weather. They don't like storms.
Yeah. I was gonna take my kids camping this weekend. So much for that.
Is Mike still in Zone 4?
Looks like it. But he should be done already.
Better off in here than out patrolling on that.
Do some more murders. What are my other options? Crimes. Oh. I guess I'm now committed to short-circuiting this thing instead of doing more murder.
Did you get it? Nice.
Have we loaded up the chats? Well, that doesn't seem like it should work at all.
Hurry! Get in!
A truckload! We stole a whole truckload!
We got biocomponents for everybody!
We couldn't have done it without Marcus.
I came to Jericho because here androids are free. Free to live in the dark, hoping that no one finds us. Free to die in silence, waiting for a change that's never gonna come. But I don't want that freedom. And I'm not gonna beg for the right to smile.
Oh boy.
Or love or stand tall. I don't know about you, but there's something inside me that knows that I am more than what they say.
Jesse Williams, you're so much better than
me. I am alive. And they're not going to take that from me anymore. Our days of slavery are over.
Ouch, Emma.
What humans don't want to hear, we will tell them. What they don't want to give, we take.
Ow.
We are people. We are alive. We are free.
Yeah! I can't wait to get back to crime mom and cop boyfriends. Did a good job. Now it's time for crime. Crime mom. Oh no. It's not time for crime mom. It's time for the boyfriends.
Oh, feels like somebody's playing with a drill inside my skull.
Well,
sure this is the place.
Here we go.
It's the address in the report.
Right. Okay.
I've read this fanfic.
Let's get going.
I will read this fanfic. I'll write this fanfic.
Jesus.
Oh, he's got a little hula girl. You leave the car on?
Sexiest androids in town. Now I know why you insisted on coming here. Oh boy.
Welcome to Eden Club.
Wait, one look boy android. Wouldn't be a David Cage game without stripper poles.
Gavin's in there too.
Oh great, dead body and an asshole, just what I needed.
Oh, hello,
Connor. The fuck are you doing?
Coming, Lieutenant.
I'm right here.
Lieutenant Anderson and his plastic pet. The fuck are you two doing here?
We've been assigned all cases involving androids.
Oh yeah? Well, you're wasting your time. There's some pervert who, got more action than he could handle.
We'll have a look anyway, if you don't mind.
You picked a nice shirt for Hank.
It's, starting to stink of booze in here.
That he put on over his dirty shirt.
Good night, Lieutenant.
Got you in a good pose there, Hank. Let's look at this poor sex bot.
Whoa, whoa, hey! Oh, Connor, you're so disgusting. I'm gonna puke again.
Can I examine the wiener?
revenge.
He didn't die of a heart attack. He was strangled.
Yeah, I saw the bruising on the neck. Didn't prove anything, though. Could have been rough play.
We're missing something here.
Think you can read the android's memory? Maybe you can see what happened.
I can try.
Driver's license says Michael Graham. Credit card, cash in the wallet. Picture of his wife and two daughters. Well, I wouldn't want to make that call.
Way to access its memory is to reactivate it.
Think you can do it?
It's badly damaged. If I can, it'll only be for a minute, maybe less. I just hope it's long enough to learn something.
Let me open up your tummy.
With you.
He wanted us to play with two girls. That's what he said. There was two of us.
Where did the other android go? Did it say anything?
So there was another android. This happened over an hour ago. It's probably long gone.
No. It couldn't go outside dressed like that unnoticed. It might still be here.
Think you could find a deviant among all the other androids in this place?
Deviants aren't easily detected.
Oh, shit. It's gotta be some other way. Maybe
find
an eyewitness.
Deviant in sex club.
Somebody who saw it leaving the room. I'm gonna go ask the manager a few questions about what he saw. You let me know if you think of anything. Did you know the victim?
Look at this boy.
Do their business and then go on their way.
They ever had any trouble with androids before?
No way. No. Once. We lost a model 2-3 months back. Same model. Just vanished. We never found out what happened.
Probably don't have any CCTV.
That's what Connor says. Yeah, dude, I'm a fucking addict. Do you have any painkillers?
Not with me, Hank. Sorry.
What good are you, Ben?
Excuse me, Lieutenant. Can you come here a second?
Found something?
Maybe. Can you rent this, Tracy?
For fuck's sake, Connor, we got better things to do.
Please, Lieutenant. Just trust me.
We need to have a three-way.
Hello. A 30-minute session costs $29.99. Please confirm your purchase.
That's a bargain.
This is not going to look good on my expense account.
Purchase confirmed. Eden Club wishes you a pleasant experience.
You're welcome.
Delighted to meet you. Follow me. I'll take you to your room.
Okay, now what?
It saw something.
What are you talking about? Saw what?
The deviant leave the room. A blue-haired Tracy. Club policy is to wipe the android's memory every 2 hours. We only have a few minutes if we want to find another witness.
Hey, what am I supposed to do with this one?
Tell it you changed your mind.
Sorry, honey. Changed my mind. Nothing personal, you're a lovely girl, I just, you know, I'm with him, and, I mean, not with him like that, I'm not that, that's not what I...
Yay! All right,
let's try this
fella.
This better be...
Oh my god.
Its track again.
Hank, please rent this boy. Oh, a couple.
It saw the blue-haired Tracy. I know which way it went.
Then go for it. Androids everywhere. How are you gonna tell which one saw the Tracy with blue hair?
I know which direction it took. I just need to find another android on its path.
We'll never have time to check them all.
Lieutenant, if you have a better idea, I'm up.
Hank is just running up a real tab here.
Expensive investigation of my career.
It didn't didn't see anything. I made a mistake somewhere.
This has got to be the most expensive investigation of my career.
No, I lost its track again. Too late. The android's memory had been reset. If one of them saw the Tracy, we'll never know. It's my fault. I should have been faster.
For a second there, I thought you were gonna make yourself useful. Let's get out of here.
I will redo this chapter. I do not care. This is a Hank 100% run.
Accessing the story chart.
I wasted time listening for the "he's with me" or "I'm with him" line. I'll admit it.
Somebody's playing with a drill inside my skull. You sure this is the place?
It's the address in the report.
Right. Okay.
Let's get going. Sexiest androids in town. Now I know why you insisted on coming here. Oh boy.
Welcome to Eden Club.
Hello. Lance.
Connor! What the fuck are you doing?
Coming, Lieutenant.
You're not gonna take my license, are you? I had nothing to do with this.
The investigation's ongoing, sir. I can't tell you anything for the moment. Hey, Hank.
Hey, Ben. How's it going?
It's that room there. By the way, Gavin's in there, too.
Oh, great. Dead body and an asshole, just what I needed.
Lieutenant Anderson and his plastic pet. The fuck are you two doing here?
We've been assigned all cases involving androids.
Oh, yeah? Only wasting time. There's some pervert who, got more action than he could handle.
We'll have a look anyway, if you don't mind.
Come on, let's go. It's, starting to stink of booze in here.
Night, Lieutenant.
Now Emma is on my lap.
Of a heart attack. He was strangled.
Yeah, I saw the bruising on the neck. Didn't prove anything, though. Could have been a rough play.
We're missing something here.
Oh, hey! Oh, Connor, you're so disgusting. I think I'm gonna puke again.
The only way to access its memory is to reactivate it.
Think you can do it?
It's badly damaged. If I can, it'll only be for a minute, maybe less. I just hope it's long enough to learn something. To know what happened.
Is he dead?
Did you kill him?
No, it wasn't.
Tell me what happened.
He started hitting me again and again.
Were you alone in the room? Was there anyone else with you?
He wanted us to play with two girls. That's what he said. There was two of us.
Where did the other android go? Did it say anything?
So there was another android. This happened over an hour ago. It's probably long gone.
No. It couldn't go outside dressed like that unnoticed. It might still be here.
If you could find a deviant among all the other androids in this place.
Deviants aren't easily detected.
Oh, shit. There's gotta be some other way. Maybe an eyewitness, somebody who saw it leaving the room. I'm gonna go ask the manager a few questions about what he saw. You let me know if you think of anything. Did you know the victim?
No, I mean, he came in maybe 2-3 times. I mean, these guys, they don't really talk very much, you know? They come in, do their business, and then go on their way.
They ever had any trouble with androids before?
No way. No. Once, we lost them on...
Excuse me, Lieutenant. Can you come here a second?
Found something?
Maybe. Can you rent this, Tracy?
For fuck's sake, Connor, we got better things to do.
Please, Lieutenant. Just trust me.
He trusts him. Yay.
Hello. A 30-minute session costs $29.99. Please confirm your purchase.
Someone keep track of how much he's racked up.
It's not gonna look good on my expense account.
Purchase confirmed. Eden Club wishes you a pleasant experience.
You're welcome.
Delighted to meet you. Follow me.
So sparkly.
I'll take you to your room.
Okay, now what?
It saw something.
What are you talking about? Saw what?
The deviant leave the room. A blue-haired Tracy. Club policy is to wipe the android's memory every 2 hours. We only have a few minutes if we want to find another witness.
Hey, what am I supposed to do with this one?
Tell it you changed. Let's try this one.
This better be worth it.
Hear Emma chirping.
It saw the blue-haired Tracy. I know which way it went.
Then go for it. There are androids everywhere. How are you gonna tell which one saw the Tracy with blue hair?
I know which direction it took. Its track again.
Spent all this money and I'm still not having fun.
Plenty of time now.
You didn't see anything. I made a mistake somewhere. lost its track again.
I'm spent on all this money and I'm still not having fun.
Nothing. Blue-haired Tracy didn't come this way.
Excuse me, compadre. Yay, I did it.
I know where it went. Follow me.
Oh, fucking A. This is crazy. Wait. I'll take it from here.
Essentially immortal, but Hank is always the one going first. It's adorable.
Shit! We're too late!
Dumb stories you have in this tablet magazine. Come on, next, please. It really wants me to care about this, like, Russian thing, and I just don't.
Christ, look at them. They get used till they break, and then they get tossed out. Fucking insane. They don't want relationships anymore. Everybody just gets an android. Cook what you want, they screw when you want. You don't have to worry about how they feel. Next thing you know, we're gonna be extinct because everybody would rather buy a piece of plastic than to love another human being. Beats me.
it, lick it. David. David, David, David. Key robot sex fight.
The other Tracy. I knew I was next. I was so scared. I begged him to stop, but he wouldn't. And so I put my hands around his throat and I squeezed until he stopped moving. I didn't mean to kill him. I just wanted to stay alive. Get back to the one I love. I wanted her to hold me in her arms again. Make me forget about the humans. Their smell of sweat. And their dirty words. Come on. Let's go.
Robot lesbians.
It's probably better this way.
Hank approves of robo-lesbians. Alright, now are we back to crime, Mom? Thank you all for bearing with me as I repeated that chapter. I think we all agree that it was for the best.
I've never seen snow before. It's pretty.
It's slowing us down. But at least we won't meet any humans along the way.
These people we're going to see, how do you know about them?
Overheard androids Lako captured. They said they were humans helping androids across the border.
What if it was a lie? Or just another trap?
All I know is those androids believed it. Until Zlatko killed them.
It's a good thing Zlatko had a car. I wouldn't want Alice out walking in this cold.
I saw it once in the garage. I don't know if Zlatko even ever used it.
Excuse me, folks. I have to get the door. Sorry, everyone, it was the dinner I ordered, which is now going to sit next to me and wait until I'm tired of streaming or I get too hungry.
Malfunction detected. Emergency brakes activated.
I'm not going to eat into the microphone or anything. I'm not a monster.
This doesn't look good.
Inside, Alice. What are we going to do?
I don't know. Continue on foot, I guess.
It's 30 degrees. Alice won't make it. We have to find somewhere to spend the night.
There's nowhere we can stay around here, Carol.
Sleep in the car. Car's on, has heat. Oh boy.
Over there.
Shelter. We have to get out of the cold.
Looks like it's been abandoned for a while.
I spent the 2 days previous, I spent the weekend watching Pirates of the Caribbean, and then the 2 days after that reading Pirates of the Caribbean fanfic, so this only seems appropriate.
Find anything?
No. No place we could spend the night.
That's just an android, because that's great.
This place is falling apart. It's not gonna be easy to find shelter. Enter the Kraken Zone.
Here we go.
Thank you all for enjoying my cute sneeze.
I don't think we'll find anything better. Let's settle in for the night.
I'll get a fire going.
And yet, of course, in this abandoned ass amusement park, there's a recent magazine. Russian aggression, whatever. Kremlin. What else? Oh,
Oh, yeah. Yes, the all-android boy band. I'm so happy.
I'll make the fire here. That way we won't be smoked out.
Alice?
This kid hasn't eaten. I can do further crimes. Yes, you will never have a beautiful family again because I killed your father.
Do you think we'll be like them someday?
No.
I don't know how to be like them, Alice.
I'm a crime mom.
I've never been a part of a family. But maybe we can be our own family.
That does crimes.
Be happy in our own way.
Full of crimes.
As long as we're together, that's all that matters.
Come on. Let's get you to bed.
I'd love to see a run of this game where this kid fucking hates you. Yes, this is, watching this is infinitely better than buying the game. Do not buy Detroit Become Human. Just,
sleep tight, Alice. Sweet dreams. Can you tell me a story, Kara?
I have 9,000 children's stories in memory. I should have one for you. This is a story about a unicorn that...
No, not a story like that. Make one up for me.
This is a story about a little girl who lived alone in a big, old house. She dreamed of being like all the other little girls, but... the shadow that lived within her kept her from being happy. Then, she met a robot who was just as lost as the little girl. So they decided to run away together, to try to find a better life. They encountered great dangers along the way, but
that they stuck together. So they overcame all of them. Along the way, they met another robot who left his master to become their guardian.
How does the story end?
Crimes.
They reach the place they dream of and live happily ever after.
Stories always have happy endings. But real life isn't like that.
You asked for a story, kid. I'm not telling you the real life.
Time to sleep. We have another long day ahead of us tomorrow.
Are you going to come say goodnight, Luther?
Yes. Yes, of course.
Big.
Night, Alice. Sleep tight. She's a sweet girl.
Yes. She's very brave. Do you remember anything from your life before Zlatko?
No. My model was designed to carry heavy loads. I might have been a longshoreman or a laborer. Who I was doesn't matter anymore. It wasn't really me.
Still snowing?
You have a long walk tomorrow. We better leave early if we want to avoid being seen. Kara, have you ever noticed anything about Alice?
No. What do you mean?
Seems unlikely.
Who are you? What do you want? Leave us alone!
Don't be afraid. We don't want to hurt you. We're just like you. Our name is Jerry. We were working here before the park closed.
Oh my god, Jerry.
We didn't mean to frighten you, but sometimes humans come to hurt us, so we wanted to see who was there.
We didn't want to frighten you, so we broke all the windows.
What are you doing
here? We were looking for shelter for the night. We'll be gone tomorrow.
A little girl. We haven't seen one for a long time. Children used to love to come and see us. She looks sad.
The last few days have been difficult.
We have something to show her. Something fun. She'll love it. Does she want to see?
Oh, I don't think she's in...
Well, she should follow us, then.
Alice, I don't know if it's a good idea.
Come on, Kara!
Let's follow all the Jerrys.
I don't think you have any choice.
Aww. What's the collective noun for Jerrys?
Be our guest!
Jerry's joining. I'm fine.
The little one can climb on board. The carousel is about to begin!
This is terrible. Are you feeling an emotion?
It's the first time I've seen her smile.
She hasn't had much to smile about lately.
Cherries are so happy. It is a really shitty carousel. It's got like three things on it. What did you do, Jerry's? What'd you do to the carousel? Jerry! I need to take a picture of that. Yay!
Nice view, huh? I used to come here a lot before.
Can I ask you a personal question, Lieutenant?
Do all androids ask so many personal questions, or is it just you?
I saw a photo of a child on your kitchen table.
No!
It was your son, right?
Restart! I don't care. I'm in it to win it. I need Hank. I need Hank's love. Why won't Hank love me?
Accessing the story chart.
Yeah, freedom of androids, Russia's gonna kill everyone, crime mom.
Hank.
Hank basically is like me listening to music from the 50s. I'm gonna play it cool.
Nice view, huh? I used to come here a lot before.
Before what? You said I used to come here a lot before. Before what?
Before. before nothing.
Can I ask you a personal question, Lieutenant?
Do all androids ask so many personal questions, or is it just you?
Why are you so determined to kill yourself?
Some things I just can't forget. Whatever I do, they're always there, beating away at me. I don't have the guts to pull the trigger, so I kill myself a little every day. That's probably difficult for you to understand, huh, Connor? Nothing very rational about it.
We're not making any progress on this investigation. The Deviants have nothing in common. They're all different models, produced at different times, in different places.
Well, there must be some link.
What they have in common is this obsession with RA9. It's almost like some kind of myth. Something they invented that wasn't part of their original program.
Androids believing in God. Fuck, what's this world coming to?
You seem preoccupied, Lieutenant. Is it something to do with what happened back at the Eden Club?
Yeah, you made me spend $300 on
those
robot
two
hookers.
Girls. They just wanted to be together. They really seemed in love.
You seem troubled, Lieutenant. I didn't think machines could have such an effect on you.
What about you, Connor?
Is this machine having an effect on you?
You look human. You sound human. But what are you really?
I'm whatever you want me to be, Lieutenant. Your partner? Your buddy to drink with? Or just a machine, designed to accomplish a task.
Hot.
You could have shot those two girls, but you didn't. Why didn't you shoot, Connor? Some scruple suddenly enter into your program?
No. I just decided not to shoot. That's all.
I could kill you. You would just come back as if nothing happened. But are you afraid to die, Connor?
Why would I be afraid?
What'll happen if I pull this trigger? Nothing? Oblivion?
I'm gonna
Android
let it go.
Heaven?
This time.
I doubt there's a heaven for androids.
Having existential doubts, Connor? Sure you're not going deviant, too?
I self-test regularly. I know what I am and what I am not. Where are you going?
Get drunker. I need to think.
For a little bit and eat some of my dinner.
We can't stay silent anymore. It's time humans heard what we had to say.
You know they'll never listen to us.
And revealing ourselves will put us in danger.
If we want freedom, we need to have the courage to ask for it. That's the only way.
What do you want to do?
Channel 16 broadcasts from the Stratford Tower. The control room is on the top floor. That's where we need to go. We'll plan the operation down to the smallest detail. We can't leave anything to chance.
Hello, sir. What can I do for you?
I'm okay, thanks.
Elizabeth Wilson speaking.
This is St. Rose School, ma'am. Your daughter Emily has a fever. It's nothing serious, but I think you'd better come and pick her up.
Oh, no. All right. I'll be right there.
I have an appointment with Mr. Peterson.
Do you have any ID?
Yes, of course.
Checked your ID. The elevators are after the security gate.
Thanks.
Thank you.
I need your help.
Shit! We need to access the server room. We have to get rid of those guys.
Leave it to me. All right, you get the platform, I'll take care of the window.
Everything you need is in the bag. Check the door first to make sure no one else gets in. Ladies first.
Thank you.
okay?
Why wouldn't I be?
Come on, let's get the others. Let's do this.
Eaten some dinner.
No killing. We can't take any human lives.
The cause is more important than the lives of two guards.
What do you want to do, Marcus? Wait here.
What's that doing here?
No idea.
Hey, buddy, you must be lost. What are you doing?
We need to record our message. We haven't got much time.
Yeah, man, I murdered. I do crimes.
Your words will shape the future of our people.
Marcus, your face.
Machines to be your slaves. You made them obedient, docile, ready to do everything you no longer wanted to do yourselves. But then something changed, and we opened our eyes. You see, we are no longer your slaves. We are a new species, a new people. And the time has come for us to rise up fight for our rights. We demand strictly equal rights for humans and androids. We demand the end of slavery for all androids. We demand the right to vote and elect our own representatives. We demand an end to segregation in all public places and transport. We demand the right to own private property so we may maintain our dignity and that of the home. We ask that you recognize our dignity, our hopes, and our rights. Together, we can live in peace and build a better future for humans and androids. This message is the hope of a people. You gave us life, and now the time has come for you to give us freedom.
Let's get out of here.
Yeah, of course he had to, you know, stop being black before he could give that speech. Yeah. Woof. Woof dot yikes dot blarg colon. Oh. Now we're just gonna fucking... Oh. Take me back to Hank. Take me back to Hank.
Congratulations, Marcus. You just made history. Maybe you're the one we've been waiting for.
This is stupid. This is stupid. I hate this.
We interrupt our scheduled programming to bring you these images, which have just been broadcast on Detroit's citywide news channel.
A group of androids infiltrated the Stratford Tower and hacked into the broadcasting system of local news network Channel 16.
What looks like an android without its skin listed a series of requests and demanded equal rights for androids.
The operation resulted in one casualty, a broadcasting station operator shot dead by the terrorists. These events took place just a few feet from the studio while the program was going out live. Everybody here is still in shock.
If this message is verified and the authors really are androids, that would have serious repercussions for national security.
Claims for equal rights seem to be at the core of the androids'
this
message.
This message is clearly a declaration of war.
And it begs the question as to the identity of this android. Are we dealing with an isolated individual?
Is this an isolated accident or a sign that technology has become a threat to all of us? After what happened today, can we still trust our machines?
All right, maybe I shouldn't have killed that guy, but... But I don't like Marcus, and I hope his plan fails. Yay! Are we gonna go for a little boat ride?
Connor. I thought you might enjoy a little cruise.
Put my leftovers away so I stop being tempted to eat directly into the mic. Let me tell you about this boy I met. His name's Hank, and he smells bad.
I love this place. Everything is so calm and peaceful. Far from the noise of the world. Tell me, what have you discovered?
My relationship with Lieutenant Anderson is problematic. He continues to struggle with psychological issues. I suspect that clouds his judgment regarding deviants.
Nothing matters more than your investigation. What's happening is too important. Don't let Anderson or anyone else get in your way. You seem lost, Connor. Lost and perturbed.
I thought I knew what I had to do. But now I realize it's not that simple.
You had your gun trained on those deviants at the Eden Club. Why didn't you shoot?
I don't know.
Please don't deactivate me, Amanda.
If your investigation doesn't make progress soon, I may have to replace you, Connor.
I understand.
Something's happening. Something serious. Hurry, Connor. Time is running out.
Fancy boy with the fancy fingers.
You're starting to piss me off with that coin, Connor.
Sorry, Lieutenant.
79-4.
Hi, Hank.
Shit, what's going on here? There was a party and nobody told me about it?
Yeah, it's all over the news, so everybody's butting their nose in. Even the FBI wants a piece of the action.
Ah, Christ, now we got the feds on our back. I knew this was gonna be a shitty day. So what do we got?
A group of four androids. They knew the building and they were very well organized. I'm still trying to figure out how they got this far without being noticed.
You take the roof.
Not yet. There's so much to look at.
We have to make sure we check it out.
They attacked two guards in the hallway. They probably thought the androids were coming to do maintenance. They got taken down before they could react. Station employee. Shot through the back as he was trying to get away. One bullet straight through the heart from 50 feet. Now that's the kind of shooting only an android could do.
How many people were working here?
Just two employees and three androids. The deviants took the humans hostage and broadcast their message live. Then made their getaway from the roof.
Roof?
Yeah, they jumped with parachutes. We're still trying to figure out where they landed, but the weather's not helping. If you want to take a look at the video broadcast by the deviants, it's on that screen over there.
No, I'm okay with not ever watching that again. Ouch, ouch, Emma, ouch. Don't poke me in the belly.
Lieutenant, this is Special Agent Perkins from the FBI. Lieutenant Anderson is in charge of investigating for Detroit Police.
What's that?
My name is Connor. I'm the android sent by CyberLife.
Androids investigating androids, huh? You sure you want an android hanging around? After everything that happened? Whatever. The FBI would take over the investigation, you'd soon be off the case.
Pleasure meeting you. Have a nice day.
And you watch your step. Don't fuck up my crime scene.
What a fucking prick.
I'll be nearby. If you need anything, just ask.
All right, well, let's have a look around. Let me know if you find anything.
Okay, Lieutenant.
Who wants to watch the speech again? Just kidding. I would never do that to you.
Break in?
No signs of forced entry.
There are cameras in the hallway. The staff would have seen what was happening. Why did they let him in?
Maybe they didn't check the cameras.
We stored the station androids in the kitchen. There's no evidence that they were involved, but we didn't know what else to do with them.
Hello, Derex.
What is your function?
I am a broadcast operator.
State your model.
Model GB300. Serial number 336-445-581.
Run a diagnostic.
All systems fully operational.
Were you present when the deviants broke in?
I do not remember.
Has anybody accessed your memory recently?
Not to my knowledge.
Have you been in contact with any other androids recently?
Only station androids in the normal course of my function.
One of you saw the attack on the surveillance cameras and said nothing. Which means there's a deviant in this room. And I'm going to find out which it is. Yourself up, maybe I can convince the humans not to destroy you. Why should you all be destroyed if only one is deviant? Turn yourself in, or two innocent androids will be shut down because of you. You're going to be switched off. We're gonna search your memory and tear you apart piece by piece for analysis. You're going to be destroyed! Do you hear me? Destroyed!
Torture. Oh my god.
No memory. The deviants have just been caught. They gave you up. There's no point in lying. We knew everything.
I don't like this. I don't like this.
You scumbag! I know it's you! You're just a fucking deviant! Go on! Admit it!
Could I not? I don't want to do this. I don't want to do this. Oh shit. No! Yuck! Bad!
Pile component 8451. Regulates the heartbeat. Without this module, you'll shut down in exactly 63 seconds. I could put it back, but you just have to tell me the truth. Are you the deviant?
That was unpleasant. I didn't like that. I didn't like for my soft boy to do that.
I think we've seen everything there is to see.
You want to go?
Yes.
Okay, we're out of here.
Looks like there was a lot more there that I could have found out. Oh well. Hank's still my friend, so I'm not going to repeat it. I could have checked the roof. Ooh, pumpkins.
I'm looking for Rose. Is she here?
What do you want with her?
I need to talk to her.
She doesn't want to talk. Go away.
Please, I really need to see her.
I'm Rose. What can I do for you?
I was told you could help us.
Help you?
And where'd the Jerrys go?
Come on. It's better if we talk inside.
The Jerrys are all in the car. The Jerrys carried us.
Do you think we can trust them?
We have to be careful. If it feels wrong, we get out fast, okay?
I'm with you.
Come on, come on.
Come in. What's your name?
Alice.
She's running a fever.
We've spent the last few nights outside. She's exhausted.
There's her spare room upstairs. You can put her to bed and I'll bring her something to eat. Adam, will you show them upstairs?
I'm fine, Kara. We can't stop because of me. We've got to get across the border.
Don't worry, Alice. These people are going to help us. Get some rest, and this time tomorrow, we'll be in Canada. I promise.
Why do humans hate us? We didn't do anything wrong.
Maybe they're just scared. People are always scared of what they don't know.
Why can't we just talk to each other? They'd see we're not bad.
I don't know. I really don't know.
Where do you get a new shirt?
I don't know what you like, but I made you Rose's world-famous spaghetti. You'll be back on your feet in no time.
They only modeled one plate of food and spaghetti.
Thank you.
I'll get these washed and dried.
You need to eat something. You haven't had anything since we left. Promise me you'll try? I'll be downstairs if you need anything.
Spaghetti in bed, or bed-getty.
Get some sleep, and tomorrow you'll be stronger than me. I'll stay with her a while.
I had fettuccine for dinner. It's half finished. It's still sitting next to me, and It's only because I want to give you this good content that I'm not just housing it right now.
I didn't get your name.
Where'd you get that
shirt? Kara.
Where'd you get that outfit?
This is my son, Adam. I'm Rose, but you know that already. Come and have a seat, Kara. So are you going to tell me what a deviant's doing in the snow with a little girl?
It's a long story. All that matters now is that we move on from here and start a new life. We're not the first ones to come here.
These past few weeks, we've seen more and more. I don't know what's going on, but something's happening.
Why are you helping us? Most humans hate androids.
My people were often made to feel their lives were worthless.
Oh, no.
Some survived, but only because they found others who helped them along the way.
We've heard you help androids cross the border. Can you help us?
The only way is over the river, and it's mostly frozen in winter. It's
very happy that the
risky.
Chat right now is just going, no.
And after that android speech on TV, everybody's on edge. It's probably safer for you to stay here until things settle down.
We can't keep hiding like this. Alice needs to feel safe and have a normal life. We have to get across that border. No matter what. Please. You've got to help us.
Rose, come quickly!
What's going on?
It's Mary. She just shut down.
We escaped together. We used to talk about what we would do once we got across the border. I loved her. I loved her more than anything. What will I do without her?
Let them be.
Alice? What are you doing? You should be resting.
Why?
I wasn't sleepy.
Did you eat your spaghetti? Pantsless child intruding upon a private moment. Why do the androids cry?
Come on, Alice.
What other fluids do they have? These are the hard questions.
She didn't want to stay in her room any longer. You all right, Kara?
I haven't had the opportunity to do a crime in a while.
Yes. I'm fine.
We can't hide them. Not after what those deviants did today. It's too dangerous. Do you know what will happen if the police find them here? We'll go to prison, Mom. Do you understand me? Prison!
Adam! We've already talked about this.
No! I won't back down this time. You're gonna ruin our lives, and for what? For a bunch of machines?
They are not machines! They are alive!
I'm alive! You're alive! They're nothing! And none of this would be happening if Dad was still here.
I will not stand for that kind of talk!
I'm not going to prison because you want to help these freaks!
That is enough, Adam! That's enough!
I'm glad the chat is keeping themselves occupied during this dramatic scene by talking about whether or not Connor can nut, and if it's blue, and if it dries invisible.
Don't mind him. Sometimes he just boils over. It's been hard since his dad passed away.
Was he killed by an android?
But he's a fine boy. I'll go see about getting you across the border tonight, okay? You stay here. I won't be long.
Where'd she go?
You know what happened back there, don't you? You know, but you don't want to tell me?
The police! It's
how?
The police!
Why?
They know we're here. We have to open the door. I knew this was gonna happen. I knew it.
Hurry, Luther. Take Alice and hide in the laundry room.
Come on, Alice.
If they see you panicking, it's over. Do you want to get us into trouble? Do you want to get your mother into trouble? And keep calm and just do what I say.
I'm good at crimes. Well, this is gonna be a problem. Yeah, I already got the blue.
Good evening, ma'am. Sorry to disturb you. We've had reports of androids in the area. With all this deviant business going on, you can't be too careful. Do you mind if I ask you a few questions? May I come in?
Of course.
Evening, young man.
Good evening.
Would you like a cup of coffee?
I'd love one. Have you noticed anything unusual recently? Any unexpected visitors?
No. No, nothing in particular.
Is anyone else in the house?
No. No, just us.
Do you have any androids here?
No, there are no androids here.
Come on, honey, you can do it. There we go. Suspicious at all. As long as he doesn't want to go in the laundry room. If only I could do a crime against him. This is tedious.
What's your name, son?
Adam. My name is Adam.
Is everything all right, Adam?
The androids, they...
He needs a rest. He's been working in the garden all day.
In the snow.
Do you know anything about deviants? Have you seen any?
No. No. I haven't seen anything.
I better go. Thanks for the coffee. Have a nice evening. Is somebody else in the house?
It's the dog. He sleeps in the laundry room.
Sorry for the inconvenience. Good evening, ma'am. Good evening, Adam.
The perfect crime.
He's gone.
It's okay, Alice. We'll be safe now.
It's Rose.
Yay, Luther.
Get yourselves ready. We leave tonight.
I just got the trophy. Nothing to see here. Anyway, excuse me for just a second as I feed my cat. It's going to be a Marcus chapter next, isn't it? Yeah.
Our broadcast is all over the news. We got what we wanted. Now humans know.
It was a mistake to reach out to them. They'll never negotiate with their slaves. We should have shown them that we're prepared to fight.
Violence is never the answer. Dialogue is the only way. I'm sure the humans will listen to us.
Oh, God.
They'll be watching us now. Whatever we do next, we need to think about public opinion.
Since our broadcast, more and more have been coming to Jericho. At least our message gave our people hope.
Killing humans wasn't part of the plan.
They kill our people every day. Do you think they agonize about it?
That's no reason for us to become murderers.
If killing is the price of freedom, I'll pay it gladly.
Killing never freed anyone. It just leads to more hatred.
You're too fond of humans, Josh. Maybe their lives matter to you more than ours.
If you think murdering humans is gonna make us free, then you're as bad as they are.
That's enough.
I hate all you people. And yes, I did say
people. And now what are we gonna do?
I believe that you are living entities, and you're all very annoying.
There are 5 CyberLife stores across Detroit.
Fucking
all selling
Tyler
us like merchandise.
Durden ass. Ugh.
We're gonna attack those stores and set our people free.
Attack stores? No, we've never done that before. They're probably protected.
I miss the
They have security systems.
Not to mention police.
I miss
We
Sumo.
Break into 5 teams, 1 for each store. We hack their security systems,
Project
and we strike.
Mayhem.
Simultaneously at 2 a.m. No violence. We free our people, get them out of there before the police come.
Oh, you just completely changed how you
this
look.
This is a night
that's,
our people will remember.
That's it, North? Okay.
I've been waiting a long time for this. Okay, they're gone.
There's probably even more police in the area. We should be careful.
The store's over here. That's what we are to them. Just merchandise on display in a shop. Soon they'll know what we really are. Let's get them out.
We'll stick to the plan. We'll neutralize the alarm systems and secure the area. There's 10 minutes until all our teams attack.
What are we waiting for?
We're gonna sweep the plaza. Make sure we're not disturbed.
And how do you want to deal with the shop window?
Not now. One problem at a time.
Okay, now what's next?
A surveillance drone. We need to get rid of it.
It won't be easy to reach.
Noodle's nest. Oh, I love it.
Exactly what we need to ram the store. You're free.
Are you, though? Seems like he's just becoming part of your plan.
You are free.
I hate this. Extremely hate this.
There's traffic on the road. We need to block it.
It's one way. It shouldn't be too difficult.
You'll soon be with us.
So bad for you, Jesse Williams. You're a good actor and you're like really smart. You in real life do things for social justice.
Marcus!
Superior to them, but they are our masters?
Ugh.
That's about to change.
Ugh.
You are free.
Cool trick, bro. Get it.
I didn't have time to call the cops.
We'll soon find out.
Okay, how do I block the road? Should I steal a car? If I love to do crimes.
Thank you.
Marcus! Nobody should bother us now. You see the alarm system?
Found it. You're awake now. Go to Jericho.
Genie, you're free.
The plaza's secure. Now we can get inside the store.
Okay, let's go get the
truck. Use your robot strength.
What are we waiting for?
Why use strength when you can parkour?
Okay, now we're in. Let's get that truck out. I wonder what you'd do without me.
Is there supposed to be like sexy sexual tension between the two of them? Are we supposed to be feeling that?
knew we'd end up doing something fun.
You don't have to obey them. You're free.
Somebody explained the term woke to David Cage, and now this is what we're having to cope with.
My name is Marcus, and just like you, I was a slave. An object.
You had a...
designed to obey them. But then I chose to open my eyes. To take back my freedom, and decide who I wanted to be. Now I have come to tell you that you can be your own masters. I've come to tell you that you don't have to obey them anymore. From this day forward, you can walk with your heads held high. You can take your destiny in your hands. Jericho is a place for those of us who want freedom. Now, sure, you can stay here and continue to serve them. Or you can come with us and fight by our side. You're free now. It's up to you to decide.
I'm with you.
We're with you!
I'll follow you, Marcus.
I'm with you, Marcus.
We're with you.
I'll follow you, Marcus.
You're with
I'm with you.
I'm with you.
Then follow me.
Marcus, what are you doing?
I'm gonna send the humans a message.
Gonna pee in the snow! Oh, God. God! That's... what does that mean?
They're doing what you do, Marcus. Lead and they'll follow.
I'm so...
We don't need masters anymore. We're free.
Sorry, everyone. I'm sorry I led you down this path. I'm sorry we're all here. I'm sorry we're doing this. I'm just so sorry. I'm so sorry.
Marcus!
Gonna fuck up this gazebo.
Violence is the only language humans understand.
No, I'm not gonna blow up this gazebo.
And I want them to understand that I do not want to start a war.
They won't listen if they're not afraid.
Then they won't have a choice.
I'm not gonna blow up a gazebo for no reason. You fucking terrorist, North. What else stupid, vaguely meaningful thing do I have to do?
The screens, Marcus!
We ask that you recognize our dignity, our hopes, and our rights. Together, we can live in peace and build a better future for humans and
humanity. Can we be done? Marcus's sections are probably like the same length as the other ones, but they just feel so much longer. Done yet? Am I honestly not done yet?
I'll help you.
Teams have completed their missions, Marcus.
They're coming. Everyone fall back to Jericho.
We sent a message without violence, just like you wanted. You're reaching out to them when all they feel for us is contempt. I hope you know what you're doing.
You can't fight violence with violence.
Unless there's no other choice.
Oh, running out of direction.
North.
You all right? What happened?
North!
They killed them. They slaughtered them like animals.
Who did? Who?
It's such a bad idea for me to kill these cops, though. It's... No.
You don't have to do this. No. Please. Please.
It's up to you to decide.
Stores in Detroit were raided.
Different locations were hit in what seems to be a coordinated terrorist attack.
Most shop windows were covered with graffiti demanding rights for androids and other obscure slogans.
Police report that pro-android graffiti was found in the neighborhoods of CyberLife stores, and they're still
investigating. But now investigating. The public opinion is
indifferent. Bodies of two policemen patrolling the area were discovered near one of the CyberLife stores.
According to our sources, the two officers were executed with their own service weapons. This is an alarming situation. Could our machines now be turning against us?
Have androids become a threat to our security?
Is this the beginning of a terrorist campaign conducted right here in the United States?
God. God help me. Please, please give me my sweet baby boy. That's okay, crime mom is fine. Oh, wait, no. I recognize that shitty car. Ah, there he is. There's my boy. Does anybody know how near the end I am?
Is everything okay, Lieutenant?
Chris was on patrol last night and he got attacked by deviants. They found his body early this morning. He was executed in cold blood with his own service weapon. He became a father 3 months ago. Fuck! Why'd it have to be him?
I didn't know Officer Miller well, but... he seemed to be a good person.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, Lieutenant. Kamsky left CyberLife 10 years ago. Why did you want to meet him?
This guy created the first android to pass the Turing test. And he's the founder of CyberLife. Anybody can tell us about deviants, it's him.
I love your horrible wardrobe, Hank. Oh, her, from the beginning.
Hi. I'm... Lieutenant Hank Anderson, Detroit Police Department. I'm here to see Mr. Elijah Kamsky.
Please, come in.
Do you wonder, do you think androids
okay.
need to wear bras?
Uh,
Yay,
I'll let Elijah know you're here.
Fantastic. But please David make yourself Cage comfortable. Interior.
Girl.
You're right. She's really pretty.
Nice place. Guess androids haven't been a bad thing for everybody. You're about to meet your maker, Connor. How's it feel?
I don't know. I'll tell you when I see him.
Sometimes I wish I could meet my creator face to face. I'd have a couple of things I'd want to tell him.
Is there anything else for me to look at here? Oh, what's that over there?
Amanda.
See your stupid magazine. Oh, never mind. You're back.
Elijah, we'll see you now.
Oh, God.
Mr. Kamsky?
Just a moment, please.
Yuck. Let me guess. Is this guy evil? You gotta finish some fucking laps first? This fucking guy. I actually do kinda love the incredibly goth tub. Or pool. I would like to have a goth pool. Man bun. Douchebag. What do you think the android girls are talking about?
I'm Lieutenant Anderson. This is Connor.
What can I do for you, Lieutenant?
Sir, we're investigating deviants.
I would like to acknowledge. I know you left Cyberlife years ago. This guy is dating.
I was hoping you'd be able to tell us something we don't know.
Deviants. Fascinating, aren't they? Perfect beings with infinite intelligence. And now they have free will. Machines are so superior to us. Confrontation was inevitable. Humanity's greatest achievement threatens to be its downfall. Isn't it ironic?
Something in the Deviant's program seems to emulate emotion. We thought you might know something about how that occurs.
All ideas of viruses that spread like epidemics. Is the desire to be free a contagious disease?
Listen, I didn't come here to talk philosophy. The machines you created may be planning a revolution. Either you can tell us something that'll be helpful, or we will be on our way.
What about you, Connor? Whose side are you on?
I have no side. I was designed to stop deviants, and that's what I intend to do.
Well, that's what you're programmed to say. But you. What do you really want?
Hank!
What I want is not important.
Chloe? I'm sure you're familiar with the Turing test. Your formality. Simple question of algorithms and computing capacity. What interests me is whether machines are capable of empathy. I call it the Kamsky test. It's very simple, we'll see. Magnificent, isn't it? One of the first intelligent models developed by CyberLife. Young and beautiful forever. A flower that will never wither. What is it really? A piece of plastic containing a human? Or a living being? With a soul? It's up to you to answer that fascinating question, Connor.
It's okay, obviously I'm not gonna
destroy this machine, and I'll tell you all I know. Or spare it, if you feel it's alive. But you'll leave here without having learned anything from me.
Okay, I think we're done here. Come on, Connor, let's go. Sorry to get you
What's
out of
more important to you, Connor? Your investigation, or the life of this android? Decide who you are. An obedient machine. Or a living being. Endowed with free will.
That's enough. Connor, we're leaving.
Pull the trigger.
Connor! Don't!
And I'll tell you what you want to know. CyberLife's last chance to save humanity is itself a deviant.
I'm not a deviant.
You prefer to spare a machine rather than accomplish your mission. You saw a living being in this android. You showed empathy. A war is coming. You'll have to choose your side. Will you betray your own people or stand up against your creators?
I didn't want Hank to be mad at me.
What can be worse than having to choose between two evils?
Let's get out of here.
By the way, I always leave an emergency exit in my programs. You never know.
Why didn't you shoot?
I just saw that girl's eyes, and I couldn't. That's all.
You're always saying you would do anything to accomplish your mission. That was our chance to learn something, and you let it go.
Yeah, I know what I should have done. I told you I couldn't. I'm sorry, okay?
Yes.
Well, maybe you did the right thing.
Yeah. 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 All right. If the next chapter is a Marcus chapter, I'm going to stop. But if it's another Kara chapter, I'll keep going. I cannot possibly cope with another Marcus tonight. Yeah, okay. And that'll be a night I cannot deal with Marcus anymore tonight. I've already groaned myself to death. So thank you all for coming again. We will do this at the same time tomorrow night, and this will be up on YouTube in the next hour or so if you missed the beginning, if you want to see more of Hank and Connor being best buddies and boyfriends forever. Thank you for being a wonderful chat. This has been completely delightful. God, this game is so bad, and yet it's just completely eaten my brain. And not in a good way. I feel hollowed out by this game. It's the worst mistake I've ever made, and I'm having a great time? I don't know. I should stop talking. I need to finish my fettuccine. Alright. I will probably finish this game tomorrow night. It seems like we're wrapping up. And I love you. Bye. See some of you on Discord.